What's going on, Shady people? ShadyPenguinn here, welcome you back for another episode of our Pokemon Alpha Sapphire playthrough. And before we get started, if you can, please show some Shady love to that like button. I've got some news to talk to you guys about in this episode, not really to this series, but just for the channel now. If you missed yesterday's episode, I will address this again. Like I said, I will do for the next couple episodes. Shady Side Gaming is rest in peace. Now, if you want to know more information on that, go watch yesterday's episode of Alpha Sapphire. I don't want to keep mulling it over in the same series over and over again, but this will probably be the last time I mention it. I figure you're not going to miss... If you're watching the series, you're not going to miss both these episodes. You'll eventually see them. So in the next Wi-Fi battle, I'll mention it, and that'll probably be it. But we're going to go in today, and a lot of you guys want me to use Kyogre. A lot more than I thought would want me to use it. And I don't have a problem with that. Let me tell you that I do not have a problem with that. The only thing about Kyogre, is that we're going to have to... we're definitely going to have to go ahead and teach him Surf. Plus, you get to surf on him when you teach him Surf, which is really, really cool. But we're gonna... Well, actually, we don't need to teach him Surf, now that I'm thinking about it, because once we get to a point where we have to surf, which I think is right now, we can teach our... Oh, this stinks. You know what? We're gonna teach him Surf. We're just gonna teach him Surf. You know what? It's a high base power move. It's not the end of the world if we teach him Surf. It really isn't. Let's see. Let's go ahead and give ourselves a little bit of surfing. Apparently, you actually see Kyogre when you surf on Basin Lord. When you surf on him, the sprite becomes him, kind of how the Whalmer became the sprite with the sprite. And apparently, if you dive on Kyogre too, it also becomes the sprite. We're gonna go ahead and get rid of Body Slam, because as much as Nappy preaches the physical Kyogre, I'm not convinced yet, so let's go ahead. I actually want to check out the nature and whatnot. I'm sure some of you guys just saw it because you're looking for that kind of stuff. But I actually didn't, so we're going to go ahead and see summary of the Basin Lord. Master Ball. Oh, wait a minute. I got a timid Kyogre? That is incredible. Oh my goodness. I will keep that, ladies and gentlemen. I will keep that. Well, I also want to give him the orb, because if you're going to use Kyogre and you're playing Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire, You might as well use Primal Kyogre. You know, you might as well. I don't see a problem. I do not see the problem at all. I'm ready to go. I am ready to go right now. We're gonna go ahead and take on Wallace, the 8th gym leader. Is his name Wallace? For some reason, I always look at this. Oh, that looks so sick. I always doubt that Wallace is the name of the gym leader. Let me just see. I don't want to talk to the man. Wallace. Because you have Wallace and Wally, and that always threw me off for some reason. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, this is ice puzzles. Hold on. I'm not trying to fall down there. We got Kyogre. To be honest, you guys want me to use this Kyogre? I'm not going to complain. But I don't think it's going to make the game any harder than it already is. How can we do this? Let's do it this way. I should definitely be using the D-pad for this, because this could get awful tricky, awful fast. Did I mess up already? It's possible. Oh, I messed up, didn't I? Maybe not. Let's see. Let's see if this actually works. Oh, we did it first try. Oh my goodness, I am proud of myself. Now this one I don't like. Yeah, I don't like this one at... I don't like this one at all. I have no desire to do this one. Oh, gosh. There's no way I'm going to do this in the first try. I think I already messed up. Yeah, I already messed up. It's done. Falling down. It's done. Oh, but at least I didn't have to verse anyone. Oh, okay. Oh, never mind. I should teach you how harsh battles can be. You can teach me how harsh battles can be. You do that, my friend. I'm really excited because this game has been out for a week to the day. Has it only been a week? No, 2 weeks. It's been out for 2 weeks now, and I still haven't beaten the bloody game, which is kind of crazy. I've never done that with a Pokemon game before. I've actually never really taken longer than a week at most to beat any Pokemon game I've ever gotten, barring, like, Blue. Because that was my first Pokemon game, and I was, like, 6, and I was just like, oh my gosh, Bulbasaur! And I would just run around with Bulbasaur and hope that maybe one day he would be my friend. I don't know. So... definitely different for me. The Huntail is level 43. And it's gonna go for an Ice Fang? Okay, Huntail, you do that. You go for the Ice Fang. I shouldn't feel tired. Maybe it's because I didn't finish my cup of coffee. But I feel tired. I feel very tired today. Oh, what I wanted to talk to you guys about. Oh, that's right. You guys see the new games coming to the channel, and I'm really excited for it. With that, A new outro is coming. Not my words, don't worry, Keep It Shady is forever what I say. But the nice little purple Keep It Shady, I'm gonna miss it a lot, to be honest, and it'll be continued on this series because we're almost done with this series, and I don't want to throw a new outro on a series and have it be all whatever, although it would be perfect on this type of series because you'll see what it is. But for Wi-Fi battles, if there's a Wi-Fi battle today, I'm having a little bit of trouble with my internet. I actually don't have internet right now, I'm recording this, but if there's Wi-Fi battles today, there'll be a new outro on it, and I'm really excited because it's just something that I should have done a long time ago. I remember I got that outro, fun story if you're actually watching this LP, I got that outro for $5 on like a website like Odd Jobs or Odesk or something like that. Someone made it for me. And that's, I chose the font, I chose the color. That was back when I had maybe like 2,000 subscribers. That was last year, I would say last November when I got that outro. Because actually yesterday, I just realized, December 30th, last year is when the channel hit 5,000 subscribers. This is not a good matchup for me. Oh, Golduck's not actually part psychic. I always think Golduck's part psychic. Do you guys have any common misconceptions when you're playing the Pokemon game? Like, is there anything you constantly forget? Like, for me, it's Golduck not being psychic. I always group Golduck and Starmie together thinking they're water psychic, but they're not. And you're gonna go for a Zen Headbutt on a Metagross that resists it 4 times. Good call, trainer. No wonder why you're in the gym. But let me know in the comment section below using the hashtag mistakes, Pokemistakes, what your common mistakes are that you make in Pokemon. Or are you perfect? You never make any mistakes. I know a couple people like that. But for some reason, whenever I'm like quickly playing a game or thinking quickly, like I'll always remember after the fact, like Golduck is not actually, he's not actually psychic, no. But I'll always initially be like, crap, that little dot on his head, he's gotta be a psychic. And I guess in Generation 1, I would always have psychic on my Golduck, so I always thought that it was psychic. I really don't know, I have no reasons. We're gonna see what this Leaf Blade does to a Wailord, Pinocchio. Is that a crate? It's not, oh my gosh. I really did not expect that to Oko. I know I'm a few levels higher, but I didn't expect that. And that's why I was trying to skip the trainers in this gym, because I know experience share, you shouldn't be using it, blah, blah, blah. But also, like, this is just a casual LP. It's not a lock. I'm not trying to go super hard on the paint. The paint can wear. I'm not trying to wear it. If it wears, it wears. If it doesn't, it doesn't. You know what I'm saying? And last, Andrea can send out Ludicolo all she wants. She can send out all she wants. It's not going to matter, because I'm opening up with a Metagross. Metagross is not having a good time in this gym. This watered down experience. Oh, I didn't Mega Evolve. Well, that was a mistake. Simus just does without the Mega Evolution. It's still a 2-hit KO. So you know what? I ain't got no worries. I ain't got none of them. I'm really excited. I think a lot of you guys, obviously not all of you guys, but a lot of you guys want me to try to finish Iron Bread. And I'm gonna have to wait until my brother goes out or something, if he goes out at all, because that game involves a lot of screaming. A lot of screaming. And I don't want to piss him off too bad. It's bad enough that he's got to listen to me talk about Pokemon all day. So I don't want to scream my head off at Bread while he's home. Now, I don't remember how I did this exactly. Oh, it's already done. Oh, that's awesome. Was it like that in the original game? If not, kudos, Game Freak. I think I already messed this up. Hold on. How can I do this and not mess this up? She doesn't want to battle me. Well, maybe I can actually go on those brown spots? Huh. So I didn't mess that other one up. But I think you can do it without going on the brown spots, and that's what I'm gonna try to do. And I think we did it. I think. Oh, come on! Come on! Ugh! I hate this puzzle. Oh, wow, they both turned around at the same exact time. I almost said simultaneously. That was the correct word. It's cool because with the 3DS, this is clearly all in the same room. There's no, like, black screen loading time for this. And I like that, like, when you fall, it's all one giant room. The gym design is fantastic. I haven't mentioned it, but the gym design is awesome. All right, so how is the question? Okay, well, I guess if I'm going to use the brown tiles, then I know how to do it. But I was trying not to. Because now I can just go like, oh, I think I messed up. I think that actually messes me up. That messes me up. No! This is getting, I am bread all over again. This is I am bread. I'm bread. I am not toast. I have not toasted yet. Come on. Come on, little ice cube. All right, let's do what we did last time. We did this. All right, I like that. That I'm a fan of. Not all this sidestepping stuff. See, this is fine. Now, if I want to use the brown, I think I just messed up. If I want to use the brown, I gotta leave this one tile open. Let's try it like that. Let's see if I leave that one tile open. Oh yeah, using the, I don't even care if I had to use the platform. I'm fine with that. All right, so we know that Wallace is the water type gym leader. So we're gonna open up with Smaug, our starter, to beat the eighth gym leader. And we know Wallace is a little bit, I mean, he's not stuck up, but I feel like he might be.
Allow me to formally introduce myself. I am Wallace, the gym leader of Sitopolis City. I'm fashionable, wearing a scarf. There's something about you, a difference in your demeanor. I think I sense that in you. What happened inside the Cave of Origin and what you did there, our upcoming battle will make it at all clear. Now show me. Show me the power you wield with your Pokemon. And I, in turn, shall present you with a performance of illusions in water.
Is this guy like Zabuza?
By me and my Pokemon.
That's probably not how he sounds in the show. I don't think that's his voice. He looks like he could be a cool dude, but he also looks like he's like, I don't know, not a cool dude, I guess. I've also changed the lighting again in my room. Fun facts. But I think it looks better now. Just slightly. I just moved my lamp over to this side, so this side's a little bit brighter. So it's not completely dark. You open up with a love disc and you're the eighth gym leader. Nope. I'm done with this game. I can't. I'm not gonna lie, I'm getting a little frustrated with the ease of this game. And I know if you didn't use experience share, but regardless, why? No matter what share I've been experiencing, why does the eighth gym leader open up with a love disc? I don't care if I had 1,000 rare candies. Why? Love disc. Why? Milotic. See, that makes more sense. I'm a Mega Sceptile, but that makes more sense. If this thing has Ice Beam and he lives Leaf Blade, Sceptile's dead. Like, dunzo. Let's see. You can't eat that. Mega Sceptile! Taking lives, crushing souls, writing down names in his death note. My goodness. Celio? Okay, so you're part ice. I'm gonna go out into Mallory because I don't wanna leave this beautiful dragon grass Pokemon in here when I got that 4x weakness to ice going on, which like, I think like, there's some statistics. Someone can figure it out, I'm sure, in the comment section, but like 60% of dragon types have a 4x ice weakness. Fully evolved dragon types, I should say. I'm not sure what the exact ratio is. I guess I wouldn't count Smaug in that anyway because he's a Mega Evolution and not a fully evolved Pokemon, but this is just all information that you probably don't need for your everyday living. Mallory's gonna eat that like an icicle pop and gonna go for another Thunder Fang. Can it connect? It does connect. Mallory has been my favorite Pokemon in this LP probably. She's so fine. Hey Mallory, you're so fine. You're so fine. You blow my mind. Hey Mallory. Hey Mallory. Majin's gonna go to level 45. I can't wait to get the Mega Stone. I cannot wait. Whiscash. All right, you're part ground, which means we're going right back out into Smaug. Because there's no one else on my team. I can't use Majin at all in this battle. A water gun will one-shot Majin. So let's go back out into Smaug. And I don't think we're having a problem with Wallace. Wallace is a little punk. He's got five. At least Wallace has 5 Pokemon. That's kind of nice. Because honestly, we haven't seen that yet. We haven't seen 5 Pokemon. Oh, man. Just ludicrous. Smaug is going to go to level 48. And Metagross to level 49. You're going to send out Seeking as your ace. Your ace is Seeking. I know some people are like,
well, Shady, you didn't use my Kyogre. What are you doing?
Well, I know it's not going to be of much use right now. And I don't want to just spam the almighty, powerful, look at the shirt, Nintendo World. But I don't want to just spam the legendary Pokemon just because I want to use it when it's right.
Bravo! Bills, golf club. Yes.
I realize your authenticity and magnificence as a Pokemon trainer. I find much joy in having met you and your Pokemon. You have proven yourself worthy of the Rain Badge. Accept it. Having that badge assures you full obedience of all you Pokemon. Isn't there like a Dragon's Den in this game, or am I thinking of a different game?
And so you never forget the battle we shared.
Here! Waterfall. Wait, the gym leader gave us an HM instead of a TM?
The HM I've given you contains Waterfall. And yes, it also has a certain elegance. You can sometimes flinch. Now with the vow of the Rain Badge, you can use this HM.
Well, that's kind of a cop-out. I think it did in the original game too, but still a cop-out. Give me a TM! Give me...
Evergrande, but it is a different use of Pokemon. The rumors that reach me on the wind whisper that Professor Burton Litterer has created a more powerful Pokedex.
All right, so we gotta go to Little Root right now. The rumors reached the 8th gym leader that we have to go to Little Root and get ourselves the more powerful Pokedex. A much more powerful Pokedex, apparently. Now, my question is, isn't there like a dragon? I really think that there's some sort of Dragon's Den. We don't have Fly, but
we have the Eon Flute.
Register that bad boy and use it.
Latias!
That sounded so cool.
Jump out of the Pokebox and let me soar on your backside.
First you shall Mega Evolve. Ooh! Woo. Nice and same auto for them.
Oh yeah! This is amazing!
Oh, we can do tricks. R does a flip. Does L do a barrel roll?
Yes!
Okay, alright. This is my favorite part of the entire game. Oh my, I knew. Wait, what is that? Mirage Cave. You see that spot? I know this is not what we planned on doing in this episode, but I don't really care. If I was playing the game and I saw Sparkle, this is what I would do. Mirage Cave. I'm just like in awe that there was actually an entrance on the backside. Yo, I kind of want it. Wait, I already have it? Oh, because I transferred stuff over. Oh, I kind of want this thing. What would I take out for, though? It would have to be like our Mega Metagross. Maybe we will do that. No, we can't. We're too late in the game. Level 38. It's not high enough.
Let us run. Let us run now.
Oh, we got an item in here. Okay, and we got another Pokemon. That's fun. It's another Drillbur. See, if it was a shiny Drillbur, I could freak out on camera right now, get up in my sweatpants, and dance. I wouldn't actually dance. Sarah would. Well, actually, Shady Lady would appreciate it. She'd probably watch it over and over again. Big Pearl! Big Pearl. I don't know. I'm guessing that post-game, these things will matter a little bit more. I thought maybe there would be a Megastone on here, I'm not gonna lie. From the way that shine happened, but we're gonna jump on Latias. I'm guessing you have to see this every time, which is not a big deal. I mean, it's like the fly animation, except a lot cooler. So I'm down with that. Now let's think. We want to go to Little Root. Oh, they have a map on the bottom screen. Sweet. Slateport. Little Root isn't like over here. Route 103. Route 102. Petalburg. Verdanturf. I can't remember the exact location of Little Root. This is awesome. This reminds me of, reminds me a little bit of Golden Sun. You never do this in Golden Sun, but it reminds me of it for some reason. I don't know why. Verdanturf? Where is Little Root? Can I check my bag? Ooh, X flies up. Y goes down. Oh, that's awesome. Rustboro. You fly really fast over the region, honestly. Oh, I could do this for a long time. Okay, Verdanturf. Mallville. Let's just go backwards. Dewford. But wasn't it like over here? Little Root. Yes! I love how you can land anywhere, and I'd rather do this than fly anyway. It's kind of fun just going around the region. I'm sure a lot of you guys have already experienced this, but I have never experienced it. It's so cool. It's so freaking cool. All right, so let's go ahead and let's go get our upgraded Pokedex. I forgot the voice I gave this guy. It's been so long.
Welcome back, Shady. You must be tired after all your recent exploits. May has been keeping me updated about all of your grand adventures around Hoenn. After hearing that all you've been up to, there is something I'd definitely like to share with you. The fact of the matter is that you resolved that Kerfluffle with the Super Ancient Pokemon. A number of Pokemon never before recorded in Hoenn region began to pop up all over. Those Pokemon are precisely the subject of my many long years of research. They are Pokemon which are thought to have resided in Hoenn thousands of years ago. We'll finally be able to meet Pokemon never before seen, the very Pokemon I've pursued all these years. I'm so excited I feel like I'm about to burst! So excited that I went right ahead and upgraded the Pokedex to be ready for all of them. Now let me upgrade your Pokedex.
We got the National Pokedex.
Sweet! So, we got the National Pokedex. Hope you find all your answers. You continue to journey with your Pokedex.
Thanks, bitch. Thank you, bitch. I appreciate it.
Now that... Nope, that's not what I wanted to do. Maybe I should say hi to Mom. Let's see how Mom's doing. Mom! 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 I actually need to look at the map. I need to do more important things really quick. I thought that there was some sort of dragon's den in this game. Secret Isle. Cave of Origin. Shoal Cave. Secret Shore. A lot of secret places. I really thought that... Maybe I'm thinking of a different game. What game am I thinking of? Oh, that's Gold and Silver. Oh, that is Gold and Silver. Oh, quite right, matey. Quite right. All right, so... In that case, what we're going to do is we are going to... Fly to... Probably Seafloor Cavern. Well, if it'll fly us to the above part, that would be great. That would be perfect. We're not checking up on Mom. Forget Mom. She's all right. She's probably talking to Birch all the time. She's a single mother that's a professor in the neighborhood. He's probably got a lot of cash. She's probably trying to get the hookups. I don't trust my mom at all. Remember, IRL Mom, I love my mom. And I trust her with everything. But this Mom? No way. So look, there's another shiny thing over here. Unless it's the same one. I think it's the same one. Like, what does this mean? Mirage Cave. Somehow, there's a hair in my mouth. I'm getting awfully distracted. What's in the air? Is that a flock of Pokemon? Don't fly into me. Actually, you know what? Oh, it's a horde. Horde battle. Can we fly here yet? No, we can't. Okay, right here. There's the Elite Four, right there. Oh, well. What's the closest thing we can go to? Moss Deep looks pretty close. We're gonna land at Moss Deep instead of the Seafloor Cavern. And I have to make sure that I buy more Max Repels for our journey, but we have 8 badges and we're ready to go. We are ready to take on things that have not been taken on just yet. But first, so I don't forget in the next episode, let's go ahead and purchase ourselves some Ultra Balls. We don't have a lot of money, to be honest. In bag, we have... Alright, so we'll go to 25. And max repels. We have 2. So let's go do 38. There we go. Absolutely no money left. That's great. 3 grand. So when we come back for the next episode of Alpha Sapphire, we're going to make our way to the Elite Four, and I'm sure that means we will be going through Victory Road, as in every other Pokemon game. If you're enjoying this LP still, I know it's been a while. We are coming to the end of this before we do post-game stuff. Please leave a like rating down below. Your support means absolutely everything on this channel. It's the only reason I can keep going with making videos, so that is a good thing. Have yourselves a good day, but above all else, keep it shady.